Hey, Highlevelers, Rayo Daniel here, and I've got another exciting video about a new feature that Highlevel has been released. It's called Custom Objects. I wanted to create this video first. Highlevel has released a lot of new features, but I think custom objects are going to be something that's going to be very difficult or challenging for people who just really don't understand objects in general to understand. So hopefully I'm going to bring a little bit of clarity to this and help you understand how you can begin using this and how you can begin even potentially selling this or implementing this at the client level. So right now, one of the things I want to explain to you is a little bit about what an object is. An object literally can be anything. Right now, you already have two objects inside of the Highlevel platform that you're dealing with. One of them is a contact record. Okay, the contact record is the first object. And again, with an object, we define an object as having a name, and then we need to define other values that object can hold. Like it could have a size, it could have a color. For instance, contacts has a first name, a last name, an email address, a phone number. So right now, you can literally create an object over anything that may be important to you and then hold data regarding that object inside of the Highlevel platform now. So this is pretty exciting. So right now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hop in and show you a quick example about how you can utilize this. And I'm going to be utilizing my fake auto detailing company. And part of this company is we're going to show you how to actually create vehicles and store vehicle information inside here. So let's hop in and take a look. And hopefully as we walk through this, you'll get a better understanding of how you can use custom objects in a different way and how you can start storing data regarding that. So let's hop into it. Okay, so here we are inside of our fake auto detailing company. Now, one of the things I do want to sit back and stress is if you sit back and look at the custom objects, that is under the settings. And here you have this new objects menu here, and this is where everything is going to be located at. Now, right now, when you open this up, you will see that there's already a context in here for the object created. So what we're going to do is we're going to create another custom object. Now, I've already done this and I've been practicing with this and trying to do this. Before we get started, there are some ins and outs that I want to make sure that you know about right off the front, because these are probably questions that you already have. Custom objects are only available on the Agency Pro plan, okay? Not available on the Starter, not available on Unlimited. Agency Pro level only feature. If you don't see custom objects on a Starter plan, that's fine. You don't have access to it because it's an Agency Pro level account feature only. So that's the first thing. Now, the second thing is because the custom object is such a new release. Like literally, it was just released here within about the last couple of weeks of this video, but there are no workflow triggers or workflow actions associated with custom objects yet. I did speak to support and looking at their roadmap here, this is because custom objects are something relatively new. This is something that you could expect to see probably toward the latter part of the fourth quarter or maybe even first quarter of 2025. So these are things that if you're looking to implement this, there are no, again, are no workflows. There's no automations with the custom objects right now. All you can do is just really store and manually update and edit data regarding custom objects. So I just want to share that with you right off the bat here. I know some people might be like, it's up to you. Right now, this is a cool feature that you can now store information in and things like that. So let's hop in and take a look at getting one created. So let's go ahead and click on the add custom object. And we're going to get this screen here. Now, right now, this is, if we take a look at an example, I'm going to try to blow this up a little bit here, but we need a custom object. We need the singular and we need the plural form of that here. So it's used in different areas inside of Highlevel. Right now, being an auto detailing company, you can understand that these people deal with different types of vehicles. It's not just a car. It's not just a truck. It's not just a minivan. So right now we need something that's just all encompassing of any type of thing that we bring in here. So that's why I'm going to use the word vehicle. Because a vehicle just represents any type of object that moves or maybe even has wheels on it. So right now I'm going to type vehicle as the singular, and then I'm going to type vehicles as the plural form of this. Now, one of the things right here, it does ask for a primary display field name. Now, ultimately, if you could, the primary field is going to be probably the best interest is to choose a field that is going to be unique maybe to that particular object. So if you look at a vehicle, what is one of the things that you can think of that's unique to all vehicles? Okay. And it's right here, actually underneath here. This is just an example, the VIN number, the vehicle identification number. So right now I'm just going to type in here, VIN number. Now this right here is going to be a unique field. That's going to be different for every vehicle that we have. If you don't have one, not a big deal, but you do need to have at least one primary field to identify the object. Now, moving forward, I'm going to show you how we can create custom fields for this particular object. Remember I said earlier, any type of object has certain data. Actually, it's called metadata related to that object. Now, if you can think about it here, what are some of the things that you could have related to a vehicle? It could have a make, it could have a model, it could have a color, it could have mileage, it could have any number of things associated with what a vehicle is. So any of these things can be created as custom fields and then added into the vehicle information to populate that vehicle's record. That makes sense. Now, because custom fields have already been involved or related to GoHighLevel for a long time now, these should be pretty common to you, but the object itself may be a little bit different. So let's go ahead and get this created, and then let's just see how all of this stuff relates. Now, right now, from what I gather here, there's only one type of option you can have for this primary field, and that has to be a singular line item or text. You can't have there are other data types like data fields or monetary or things like that. You can't have any of those fields being primary. That's just the way it is right now. If you take a look here, this little internal name just shows you, if you click on it, it just shows you what are we going to call this internally. And then just going to, because there's a space here, they're using a this and they put them all lowercase, but that's all it means. And we do get the ability to change the icon of this. Now the icon, I'm going to show you visually what that looks like, but I'm going to sit back and just choose a car. And we get several different icons here of a car. Let's see, which one do I want to use? Which one do I want to use? I'm going to use this guy just right there. And then the description, I'm just going to choose vehicle details. I'm not really going to fill that out, but you can sit back and put in there and so forth, whatever you want. Now here, we've got a couple of different things here. We've got this create custom object, but we also have create and add custom field. I wouldn't do this one yet. This one kind of has some, you missed the point on this one here, but you also missed some of the other things I want to go over here. So I'm not going to choose add a custom field yet. I'm just going to create the object, and then I'm going to go in and create the custom field in just a little bit here. So let's go ahead and create this. Now it's going to take just a little bit here. Now, when we do this, I'm going to blow this back out. Custom object created successfully. Now notice we've got this nice little add custom fields here. So they want to make it very prevalent that you can add fields. But before I do that, I want to sit back and focus on the custom object screen first. So right now, if we take a look here, notice that we can delete a custom object, edit it, or then add custom fields to it here. So you can do all of that right here. Now editing it just opens it back up, but I do want to make sure you understand, you can delete a custom object, but what that's going to do, that has a cascade effect. Okay, so deleting a custom object, you then delete every association or every connection point with that custom object. So if you have a custom field that's created for a custom object, and that custom object doesn't exist anymore, then neither can the custom fields. Okay, so this could be disastrous. If you're gonna be building a vehicle and adding custom fields and adding all of these vehicle records and things like that to it, again, this could be very dangerous, because if you delete that, it deletes everything and you have to completely rebuild it from scratch. So please be cautious when you look at deleting this. Now, if we come in here and actually click on vehicles, one of the things that before we leave this custom object screen is I wanna show you is, how do you build an association? Now, this is where it gets even a little bit more abstract, because when you have a custom object like this, you can have multiple custom objects that are related to each other. Now, for a vehicle, I can't really come up with a great example here, so I'm sorry, but the one association that we can associate with is we can associate a vehicle with a contact record. Okay, so here in auto detailing, when somebody brings in their car, whoever that particular person is, we need to be able to find that particular person in our contact record, first of all. Then we can look at, okay, this contact now is associated with this vehicle. So now we can tie these two together by an association. And these are not just limited to just a contact record and the custom object. You can associate multiple custom objects if they have a relationship and related together, okay? So that's up to you to kind of define how these are built. But in order to create that connection, you will have to come into the custom object here and actually create the association between this custom object and another custom object. Now, for this one, we're going to associate the vehicle object with the contact object, okay? So we're going to go ahead and create association. And notice that right now we've got contacts. That's the only other one that we could choose right now. Now, for this owner, for a single label here for name the association, it says related object name. I'm just going to choose a customer. Or if you wanted to, you know, maybe even just you would just choose owner. That's if that's what you want. So we're just going to create this. It's going to be the owner of this object. It's going to be whatever contact record we define. Now, if we take a look here at some of these fields here, notice that these custom configure relationships. These are not coming yet. We can only do many contacts to an owner or many vehicles labeled to an owner. So that's the only kind of connections that we can actually have here. But I'm going to go ahead and click save just to get this saved. And now we actually have an association between vehicles now and an owner or a contact record. So now that we've done that, this is all we have to do. And now let's pop in and start looking at creating some custom fields for this. So now the custom field screen pops back up. This should look very familiar. This is exactly what you would normally do for it. So right now I'm just gonna do a line item and I'm gonna click next. Now notice here for the field name, again, exact same way you create this. And for this one, I would always try to make sure that your field names are unique. here. This is going to be up to you. I'm just going to do make, model, and like maybe mileage, things like that, that we can associate with a vehicle. If you have a make of a car, is it a Ford? Is it a Chevy? On the model, is it a Camaro? Is it a whatever kind of a thing? These are just ways that you can define the metadata or the data about the object that you want to store. You can, again, add as many custom fields as you want that's going to be of value to you. Now, one of the things that you can do on this one, and I'm not going to build it into this example because this thing could last forever if we want to go into it, this video, but you can have last service date. Maybe you have a field for the last time that person was in, and then now you have something that you can at least search a field of when was the last time these people were in to detail their car. So that's the kind of field that you can build, but I don't have a plan built out again in this video to be that extensive and show you. I'm just trying to show you some of the basics and help you understand custom objects and how you can use them to get your brain thinking about it and how you can implement this in your customer and your client's businesses. So right now, one of the things I do want to make sure that you do is when you have the name, notice over here, we have objects. We have a contact object, an opportunity, but now we have this vehicle object because we created it. Now, because of that, any custom object that we create will now have and that will be in this list. I just want to show you that. Now, one of the things I do want to show you here is the group name. So here there's automatically a default group called object info. Now, the folders are really just those sort of areas. You've seen them in the contact level, the additional info and things like that. Those are folders. And again, a folder is just a way to organize the metadata about the object so that when you look at the object, it appears a little bit, you know, I guess more organized. So right now I'm not going to worry about going and creating folders. We'll see where that is, but I'm just going to put it underneath the vehicle info and again, just move forward. So we're going to do that. We're going to create it. Now, here are our custom objects. Now I want to sit back and help you notice that there is an object type here. These object types have already always existed, especially when the object type, when opportunity objects came out, or now we can start creating custom fields with opportunities. That was quite a while ago. The object column now populates that shows us what kind it is. Now, notice that here, the folder that we talked about, that additional info for the contact, these are, again, just ways of being able to store that information. But right now, if we pop back here, I think for the last one, I do want to sit back and show you that notice that we have a couple of object types now called vehicle. One of them is the VIN number. Again, that was the primary key sort of field that we used to create this column. But we also have this other one called make. And notice that they're just under the vehicle info and that we have this custom object now that we can utilize inside of Highlevel. So if you're going to be sending out an email and an email campaign, you know, these custom fields now become available regarding those particular objects, just like any other custom fields for a contact and so forth. So anyway, that's just where they're at. And I'm just going to do one more field just to be fun here. I'm not trying to, everybody knows how to make custom fields at this point. I'm just going to do model, put it underneath here and click save again. So now we have at least a couple of different fields that we can fill out. So now at this particular point, this just took us a few minutes, but we've now created a custom object and we've actually created a couple of custom fields to hold data about those objects. Okay. So now let's hop back here to the main screen. Notice over here, what is this? Vehicles now shows up here on the main level as an object along with contacts. And it has our nice little, whatever that little vehicle icon I picked. So this right here is a way that you can access the vehicle information from this, because now it is its own custom object, just like opportunities, you know, is an object, contacts is an object, vehicles is an object. So one of the things to keep in mind is that I've found no way to organize this right now. So if you're going to go in and create 5, 10, 15, 50 custom objects, beware this menu option, whatever, over here on this side, these menu options are going to be quite long. Okay. And I've found no way to organize these into any kind of a folder yet on the particular menu. So just be careful that this menu option will get longer. So right now we're going to go inside of vehicles and here's a new vehicle screen that we get. Pretty cool, right? So right now we've got this nice little add vehicle. We're going to click on this button. Notice that we're going to get the primary field here. So I'm just going to do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, just as a VIN number. And I'm going to click save. Now, when we do this, here's one of the things that, again, this is, as we saw, when you create the object, we can create the object with the primary field, the VIN number here. Once we create the object, now it gives us the option of editing and putting in the metadata. This is different than when we created the contact record. So this is, I think, possibly maybe a flaw or an early bug or something like that inside the Highlevel system. But notice that it didn't, when we click new vehicle, it didn't give us a nice screen where we can put in all the metadata about the vehicle all at once and click save. It just gave us the primary field. Now, this could just be, but I don't know if this is by default or not, but just keep in mind that you will have to create that sort of VIN number here, that main field to uniquely identify the vehicle. And once you actually get this vehicle or whatever your custom object is going to be, now you get this screen right here that I want to go over. So right now we've got this, we can now come over here and let me in the way. So let's come over here and look and see what this is. So we've got the make. Let's just do Chevy, I mentioned earlier, and just do Camaro. That's fine. So right now, if I can type right here, somebody out there is making fun of me, but that's fine. Chevy Camaro. Right now, there's some other things on here. Again, we've got the hide empty fields. We've got this vehicle info folder. So as you create more and more folders, again, creating a folder for this vehicle is no different than creating a folder for, you know, any other vehicle. It's the same thing. So I'm not really going to go over that because you guys already know how to do that. But once you create the object, creating the custom field of folders is the same as creating it for a contact or anything else. But one of the things I do want to sit back and explain to you here is I did have to sit back and contact support about this area up in here, this owner and followers. Now, this is not very specific about what these are. There really is no documentation about this out as of yet. Here's what I have found out so far. The owner has to be a member of your staff member. So if you wanted to assign ownership of this particular record or this vehicle to somebody, it has to be a team member. Now, could this be the team member that's, if this was, again, the detailer in this case, we've got an auto detailing company, and every time this vehicle comes in, the same staff member always does this. Maybe you make the owner that staff member, but when you click add here, this right here only searches the, I've only got one person assigned here. This is my fake user here, but that right there, the team members are the only owners of this particular object that you can have. Now, you can also have additional followers, which are also team members as well. But where this really comes into play is when you actually specify inside of their user permissions, only assigned data, that little field inside the user permissions. And you guys can go take a look at that. But there's a particular role. Once you specify like what they have access to, there's a little toggle that says user assigned data, which means that they can only see data that's been assigned to them. That's when really this comes into play. If you don't have that toggled on at the user level, and you don't come in here and set up owner or followers, any of the users can see the data in here and edit it. So again, I don't really have any fascinating things about that other than just maybe there's going to be something in the future with regards to workflows or things like that regarding owners and followers. But as of right now, there's really nothing here regarding that. So this is, if we take a look over here, notice that there's, I'm trying to blow this up again. This is the detail sections. But now if you want to come here, there's also associations. Remember, when we created this custom object, we did create an association between the vehicle object and a contact object. So let's take a look. So right now we've got this, notice that we have a contact record, and right now we can associate a new contact. Pulls up, and all we do is just simply pull. I'm just going to pull a guest here. This right here, I don't really have a lot of any people in here. And notice that the guest is owner. This is the type. Remember, we defined that owner field already here. So I'm going to go ahead and click save. So now what we've done here is now we can sit back and actually have this probably, let me edit this view contact. So if we view this contact record here and we come down, we should be able to sit back and see an area in here for the ownership of this particular vehicle. So again, inside the contact record here, if you want to look at it, there is a new link over here. Give me a second. Notice that we have all these fields over here. You can go ahead and click on this little link here for associations. And then here, once you do that, you can simply drop down the list here and you see that's how you tie this particular object. And again, multiple objects with this particular contact, because keep in mind, people can own more than one vehicle. So if they bring in multiple vehicles, you want to make sure that vehicle can still be assigned to the same person. So anyway, hopefully that is good enough here. And let me move back here into the vehicle screen and pop back in. Again, this is what it looks like. If you wanted to, there are no like three dots over here. Just to explain the interface for this, I know I was actually inside of the edit screen. But to get back to that, you're going to have to click on this primary field. This opens it back up again. And from here, you can edit any of these particular fields. And notice I didn't save the information here, but that's fine for this Chevy Camaro. I moved away from it here. I didn't click save to save this information. But then the association here did get updated. So now we saw how the association between this object and the contact record. And then you simply just click on the contact record and it'll take you right over there. So hopefully, you know, this right here just gives you some good insights into custom objects, what they are, how you can build them, how you can use them to create associations with a contact, how you can add different metadata or custom fields in this kind of case about it, how you can add folders for all of that kind of stuff with these new custom objects and how just basically this system works. So guys, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, click on the like button, leave me a comment here, give me some feedback regarding this. I know this is a new feature. So if you have questions, you leave me a comment and I will try to find out that stuff because again, I'm here for you. If you have not subscribed to my channel, click the subscribe button to help me out here. And hey, if you have not signed up for Highlevel yet, I am a Highlevel affiliate. That's one of the ways that I get compensated. Please check out my 30-day free trial. I have a ton of bonuses, training, and so forth that's going to help you get started and be successful using the GoHighlevel platform. Guys, thanks so much for watching. Hang in there with me and have a great day. Bye-bye.